Okay, these three planes, or these three equations, are called a system of equations, and we can find out their solution using a matrix. Well, not a matrix, but matrices. And this is x, y, z, x, y, z, x, y, z. And then the constants are 15, 7, and negative 3. Let's do it like this. I'm going to write, the first row is going to be these coefficients. 1, negative 2, and 15. And then this one's going to be 2, 3, negative 1. 2, 3, negative 1. And this one's going to be 4, 10, minus 5. 4, 10, negative 5. And I'm supposed to be connected. Okay, that's matrix A, or the first matrix. And then the variable matrix is just going to be X, Y, Z. Man, that's awful. Let's see. And that's going to be like this. And that equals the 15, 7, negative 3, which is, oh man, I put 15 here, and that's supposed to be 1. That's a goof. Okay, this is 1 minus 2, 1, 2, 3 minus 1, and 4, 10 minus 5, just checking, then x, y, z. So, and then we've got 15. I caught this because I was about to put 15 right there, and I realized that I had it there. Okay, then this is 7, and this is negative 3. All right, now, so let's think about this as this. A, X equals C. I don't even know if A. Let's just do A, B, C. And we're trying to find B. We know A and we know C. We're trying to find B. So now if those were matrix, let me write it like this. We got okay. If you want to solve for this, you could just divide by this and divide by this. So X would equal this. But you can't divide by a matrix. You can only multiply by the inverse. So here's what we do. We just put in, all right, it's 1, negative 2, 1, 1, negative 2, 1. 1, negative 2, 1, and then 2, 3, negative 1, 2, 3, negative 1, 2, 3, negative 1, and then 4, 10, minus 5. 4, 10, minus 5. Okay, now we want to multiply that, but it's not that, it's inverse, because we can't divide by this, so we have to multiply by its inverse, which is division. So I'm going to go exponent minus 1, and then I'm going to multiply that times this guy, 15, 7, negative 3. 15, 7, negative 3. 15, 7, negative 3. 8, so 8 minus 2, 3. This right here is 8 minus 2, 3. So I'm just going to go And this is x, y, z. So on the three dimensional graph. And then let me get a skinnier one from back here. And then make it a little bit bigger on the front. Just try to show depth. It's not exact, but okay, this is coming towards us. Let me make that other one a little bit better, like it was getting smaller. Okay, so 8 minus 2, 3. And I don't remember which one's X, Y, or Z. It doesn't really matter. Let's just say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let me change colors here. And I get something so I can put a square. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then minus 2. 1, 2. And then 3. Which would be 1, 2, 3. So let me put a bigger one there. This right here, bam. That would be the point where all three of those planes hit. Let me see if I can try to draw a plane for you. I'm not that good at this. Let's just say we got like that, and then like, let me change different colors, see if this works out. And then we got bye-bye. And then let me do a red one. Not white would be cool. And then the next one goes, and I'm just kind of guessing, but all those planes in this thing touch at 8 minus 2, 3. Goodbye! Alright, I'll do another one. I don't know if this one was that good. But you just take the coefficients and build it in one. Take the constants and build it in another one. And then take the variables and build it in one. And then so if it was 2 by 2, it would be, this would be your first one's X and Y, your second one's X and Y, then you would have X and Y, and then you would have the two answers. And then get the inverse of this one and multiply it times this one, and then that's it. But remember, matrices, multiplication, and commutative, meaning you can multiply this times this because the rows are the same. This is a 3x3 and this is a 3x1. In other words, you can't do a 3x1 times a 3x3, but you can do the word is commutative. Commutative? You can't, it has to be entered like this. Well, for that one anyway. Okay, I'll do another video that's better.